Members who belong to the fraternity of learners and innovators, good morning. Good morning. It's not something new, it's very common these days. You will find stuff like that on YouTube and, you know, inspirational videos and all. So on count of three, 1, 2, 3, good morning.
Good morning.
I hope you guys have got resonated with that. So, I have come here just to be one of the spectators, and suddenly was offered to be one of the speakers. So that was kind of unexpected for me. But then being an entrepreneur, that is the positive aspect. You have to expect the unexpected. So that is the first lesson that I want to give you all. If you want to pursue to be an entrepreneur, you have to be ready to face all sort of situations, be it expected, be it unexpected. So guys, my name is Nilesh, and I'm nothing different from you guys. Alright, I have the same dreams, I pursue the same inspirations, the same aspirations, passion, everything is common, nothing different. Just one, that I try to listen to what that feeling told me, that I have to do something different after my graduation. So I completed my graduation in the year 2014. That was a time when I was doing my IPCC as well, CA IPCC, and I failed twice to clear the second group of CA IPCC. I cleared the first group, that was relevant. To go for the final, I had to clear the second group. So then came a point in my life when I was like, I have done with my graduation, I have to realize what to do next. So then it clicked. An idea clicked in my mind that I have to create a consultancy, HR-based consultancy. So I had only 5,000 rupees in my hand, which was totally my own pocket money, some of the borrowings which I had from my friends. I'm sure boys are good at that. So that has been in establishing my consultancy, and the two things which I did back then were, first, creating a website, which was quite, you know, simple for me, since we have GoDaddy now. GoDaddy, I'm not endorsing any brand, go on anyone, any of the brands. You'll have a website builder, create a website on your own, and then get some visiting cards published. These are the two things that you have to do, which is for which 5,000 is more than sufficient, more than enough, trust me. So I did these two things, and then I had organized an education fair. I had allotted stalls to various schools and colleges. I had charged them 25,000 for a stall, and somehow I managed, within 1 month of preparation, I managed to have some 30 colleges and universities in that fair. So that is how I started my entrepreneurial journey. But then it clicked in my mind that this is not something which is sustainable. Okay, we have to be free with me. This is an entire story. So then a moment came in my life back in the year 2015 when I met Mr. Rajesh Prasad. That time I was 22 and he was 52. So it was like he was double, or more than double of my age, and he had recently resigned from his government job. That was the situation. He was having a perfect government job, sitting in an air-conditioned room, meeting a bureaucrat, being a bureaucrat and handling everything, having 10 years of expertise in IT department and being a national awardee. So he had some plans of being an ITist, of having an ITist startup, information technology enabled startup. So when I met him, we had exchange of views, and somehow I managed to become his partner in the venture. And we came up with an idea of franchising. Like, for being a startup, as Amitesh said told in his speech, you have to be clear with the funding. Funding is very necessary. At the same time is the idea. Once you are clear with the idea, you have to start it. Don't wait for anything. That is the logic behind saying good morning all the time. If you are clear with your ideas, you can start it at any moment of time. And once you have started, just try to bag some investors. That is the second most important thing. Otherwise, you cannot sustain in the market for a long time. So, basically, people go for two things. One is the debt and the other is equity. I will not explain you about that. You are pretty good at that. So, debt is having some borrowings, be it bank or some investor. Equity is sharing your profits, sharing a portion of your ownership with some person, be it an angel investor, be it one of your partners, that doesn't matter. So I told Rajeshji that we should not go for either of them. So the question was what to do next. So we started allotting partners in various cities. Like there will be a city partner, there will be a district partner, there will be a regional partner, there will be a state partner, and this is how we have been evolving for the last 2.5 years. I will not say that we are doing miracles as of now, we are still in a planning phase. No, I will not say the planning phase, we are still in a phase where you have to look for escalation, where you have to look for going to the next level. By next level I mean going national, because as of now we are having 150 Saral Seva Kendras established in more than, I think, 24 districts. So that is the situation we have as of now, and we will try to increase it further with just one thought in mind, that whatever you want to do, be clear, be specific about it. And I'll give you a reference of a book which was suggested to me by one of my mentors. Having mentors is another very important thing. Always believe in your life. If you do not have mentors in your life, you will never succeed. Listen very carefully to a person who denies your idea. If you visit an investor and he says that your idea is not credible, your idea is not good, it's not feasible economically, listen to the feedback that he's providing you. It worth millions. So one of my investors who had denied my idea, he had given me a suggestion to read a book which is called 0 to 1 by Peter Thief. 0 to 1. So it gave me a lot of ideas that you have to be the first person in the market with the idea. And if you have an idea, click it the moment it comes in your mind. Otherwise, it can be possible that there some other person with a similar idea will enter into the market before you had even started planning. So this is the small entrepreneurial journey which I started back in the year 2014. And I'm very happy and I'm very glad that we have so many future aspirants of entrepreneurship who are sitting here very patiently throughout this session. So just give a huge round of applause for yourself. Thank you, everyone. Thank you. Thank you so much.